In the previous video, you have already seen why so many animals can live in the Amazon region. However, biodiversity is under great pressure due to deforestation. A lot of trees are cut down in the Amazon region. Although the rate of deforestation has fallen 50 years ago, deforestation has been on the rise again in recent years. Trees are legally and illegally cut down for profit, to build infrastructure and for mining. The loss from forest fires is added to that. The bottom layers of the tropical rainforest in Brazil contain many raw materials, such as iron ore. Because the raw materials are not always in deep layers, there is a lot of opencast mining. The surface is excavated. Because a large area is being excavated, this has major consequences for the tropical rainforest. Many roads are also being built. These roads provide good connections, but accelerate deforestation. New areas will be accessible through newly constructed roads where trees are vulnerable for deforestation. So, trees need to be cut down to build roads, but the construction also indirectly leads to deforestation. Furthermore, the agricultural land is expanding rapidly at the expense of the tropical rainforest. Many livestock farms move to these areas. Where the livestock farms were located, soy cultivation often arises. The production of soy has increased enormously in recent years because it is processed in many foods, is used as animal food, and also increasingly serves as biofuel. Although soy farmers claim that their business is not at the expense of the tropical rainforest, this is often the case. The ranchers who relocated for soy cultivation ended up in areas where previously tropical rainforest had been cut down. In the tropical rainforest in Brazil, a total of 30 to 35 million people live, and some of them are threatened in their lifestyle by the ongoing deforestation. In addition, their habitat is further reduced by an increase in the number of dams. Behind the dam are large water reservoirs where formerly the indigenous people lived. The tropical rainforest also plays a major role in the carbon cycle. Clearing the forest allows more carbon dioxide to enter the atmosphere, further amplifying the greenhouse effect. Finally, the tropical rainforest also plays a role in the water cycle. Part of the precipitation is released back into the atmosphere by evaporation and by transpiration of the vegetation. Subsequently, the water vapor can rain in other places. There are scientists who point to deforestation of the Amazon as the cause of droughts in Sao Paulo. So there are many negative effects of deforestation. Still, the process continues because a lot of money is being made from it. A large part of Brazil's export consists of raw materials and agricultural products. For example, about 12% of the export consists of soy, and this share is increasing very quickly. Iron ore is also an important export product. These are usually products that are sensitive to price fluctuations, which makes the Brazilian economy very vulnerable. In short, the tropical rainforest offers enormous opportunities for economic growth through logging, the extraction of raw materials, the extension of the agricultural area, and cheap electricity from dams, but this creates many negative effects.